Hello, this is a Panasonic DMR-ES35V, a dual VHS and DVD deck. It is a mid-range model from 2006 family of Panasonic DVD recorders. It is the only model in the European lineup to feature a VHS deck. On the other hand, 3 out of 6 American market models had a VHS deck. So what can it do? Obviously, it can play VHS tapes. Super VHS playback is support as well, albeit at standard VHS quality. It can play DVDs as well. And for both media types, video is sent out through composite, S-video and component outputs.
It can record on a VHS tape or on a DVD recordable disc from a variety of sources. Composite, S-video, built-in tuner and a DV input. The machine can dub VHS tape to a DVD disc, and it can dub DVD disc to a VHS tape. Panasonic suggested another use case for dubbing a VHS tape to a DVD, VHS Refresh. The refresh is achieved by using digital noise reduction and digital time-based corrector.
Some of you may suddenly start paying attention. Time-based corrector that removes jitter, straightens up a frame, and prevents picture roll. Can it work without recording on a DVD? Can it work for external sources? And the answer is yes and yes. Here is my setup from the ES35V into IO data USB 2 and into a USB port on my Windows machine.
If you want to time-based correct a video of a VHS tape, you can play the tape directly in this machine and grab the corrected signal from one of the DVD priority out ports. I prefer S-video because it provides higher quality than composite, while component video is not supported by my analog-to-digital video converter. If for any reason you want to grab an uncorrected signal, you can use DVD VHS common output, which is composite only. To time-based correct analog video coming from another media, you can play it in a respective machine like an 8mm camcorder. There are a couple of settings you may want to verify before capturing, in particular black level. For North America, theoretically you need to set input level to darker to remove the 7.5 IRE pedestal and output level to brighter to prevent expanding the luminance range. In practice, this setup was found to cause bending, so it is recommended to set input level to lighter and output level to darker. The end result will be the same, but with smooth gradations without bending. If you play a tape directly in the machine, the input level makes no difference, and the output level should be set to lighter to prevent expanding of the luminance range. The TV type setting, which can be either 480i or 480p, is used only when playing back a DVD and outputting the video through component connection, so it makes no difference for capturing VHS tapes.
How good is the TBC on ES35B? Let me show you some examples.
Thanks for coming. It's a pleasure to see all of you.
Thanks for having
us. I'm glad you could join me here this evening. Before we begin talking about the parade, and I know it's a little bit early, it's still a little nippy outside, it's hard to imagine the 4th of July being here, but before we know it, it will be. Let's talk about the committee.
This is the island of Antigua. Antigua is a rather poor island, but it has a lot of beaches. It's supposed to have 365 beaches, a beach for every year. And it looks like it has a brand new dock right there. The island of Antigua. We are in its snug little harbor. A tiny little town right ahead of us. So we're getting up. Heading down to the dining room for some eggs benedict, and then maybe we'll go over to visit an interesting place today called Nelson's Dockyard.
Is there a tide in Amsterdam? No, there's not, because we have 16 sea rocks. The 16 sea rocks are around town. They control the water tide, and they are also being used for refreshing the water, which is done 3 times a week. New water is then flowing in from the lake in the heart of the Netherlands, IJsselmeer, which is sealed off by a huge dike in the north of the Netherlands. So this IJsselmeer is a lake of fresh water. Consequently, the water in Amsterdam is also fresh. The old water flows out through the North Sea Canal. North Sea Canal, approximately 20 kilometers until the Dutch coast. So people with a little knowledge of geography will immediately conclude that all the rubbish of Amsterdam is directly exported through this canal to the coast of England.
In closing, the ES35V is not bulletproof, but it is better than nothing. I found it for $20 in a local thrift store, and for this money, it's a worthy addition to my toolbox. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. Goodbye.